Despite the catfish's highly developed auditory system, lab tests reveal they still prefer CDs over vinyl. Hunting of Fautic's keystone predators has led to a superabundance of catfish, which is just fine by local bully Rosie the Alligator. If a group of consenting adults wants to perform cryptic rites to shadow forth the prophecy of the great old ones, who am I to judge? No one knows how long a shark can live out of water. If this one doesn't return to the sea, she'll eventually find out. Catfish proves no match for the savage and relentless fury of the shark. The shark listens determinedly for the irregular low-frequency sound of an animal. I have one of those new pop-up tuck stoppers at home. Let me tell you, those things are just a magnet for hair and debris. The peace of the grotto enables the shark to approach the world with greater confidence and effectiveness. Exhibiting behavior more common to whales and dolphins, this shark is able to use biosonar to locate potential prey. Supercharged with gene-altering mutagens, the shark now has an asymmetric edge on the competition. Thank you. This mineral supplement wouldn't be necessary if this shark ate a more nutritious, well-balanced diet. Is a freshwater fish commonly found throughout the Great Lakes region, so I have no idea what it's doing here. And we should expect much angst, ennui, and poor decision-making. Another animal falls prey to the raggedy-toothed apex predator. The seawolf remains acutely aware of anything that might constitute food. what that is. Maybe a rainbow trout? Ocean remains a brutal kill or be killed world. According to the county administrator, Chuck Hucklebridge, the lack of effectiveness of piecemeal technocratic solutions here can only be solved with more piecemeal technocratic solutions. A shark's skin has chemoreceptors that taste the water for possible prey. As a result of industrial pollution and sewage wastewater, Dead Horse Lake was designated a Superfund site in 1996. Even for sharks, it's important to create personal time for sober self-reflection. Thank you. Retaliates against the shark by sending some of its most disreputable citizens. Another victim in the shark's terrifying war of annihilation. The Scourge of the Swampland, Bayou Willie.
Got a fin!
The shark's reckless behavior only further incenses Port Clovis's citizens. By putting sharks in their place, hunters ensure they'll stay in their lane, so we don't have a Planet of the Apes situation on our hands. Shark versus dolphin, orca versus giant squid, boat versus pylon. When establishing dominance, the contest is usually a deadly one, with survival as the prize.
I just know she's there.
That about wraps it up.
The hunt ends, but this is a mere pause in the eternal struggle between man and nature. Make no mistake, though shark hunters may occasionally drink on the job, they know actually that's pretty irresponsible.
Kind of regular there at Flamingo Joe's. People say it's a tourist trap. But it's the only place to get a decent Cesarac that don't have me on their do not serve list.
Yeah.
would be nice.
The battle is over, but the war goes on. Hunger is a driving force for the bull shark. The shark returns once again to her safe haven. Until local police departments settle a dispute over jurisdiction, these two remain a popular attraction for selfie-seeking snorkelers. bounty has been placed on the fugitive's shoulder.
But I think it's probably a bad idea to get in the middle of Flamingo's massive migration patterns. Just saying.
Only here can the shark discover the miracle of self-love. Humans' attention spans are short. They've already forgotten about the shark and her many crimes, so thus ends the bounty.